All right, hey, here we are back at the ModelOff 2013. I'm here with Paul Kehoe. Paul's here from Dublin, Ireland. You're one of the 16 finalists this year. Welcome.
Thank you, Bill.
All right, so hey, Paul has a great trick for us today. What do you have today?
Bill, it's just a suggestion around how better use of hyperlinks. Hyperlinks can be very useful when linking from one sheet to another, particularly when you want to set up an index page, but there's one area where Excel doesn't respond well.
Okay, so you want to have like a table of contents and be able to link out to various parts of the model or something like that, right?
Exactly, yes.
Great. Okay, so I think I've done hyperlinks. Go ahead and show us how to set one up and what the problem is.
Sorry, Bill. So if I wanted to create a hyperlink, I just click on the insert, hyperlink, and normally you go place in document, and if I want to pick linked to the other another sheet, so the data sheet, in this case, just click on the sheet name, just click on A1 and press OK, in which case, when I click here, it will jump over to the sheet.
Nice. Oh, yeah. But wait, I misspelled the data sheet. You got to fix that.
So if we recorrect the sheet name, I now hit the hyperlink. To find Excel is unable to read it.
So Excel can deal with the sheet being renamed if it's in a formula, but if it's in a hyperlink, then it doesn't work.
Exactly.
Oh, what a horrible problem. Okay, so I guess one thing you could do is make sure that all your sheets are spelled right before you create any hyperlinks.
True.
Okay, but you have a better way.
But yes.
All right, let's go.
My suggestion would be to create a range name. So go to somewhere on your target sheet and click in arrange name. So typically I just go sheet, data. That has now created a range name. So if I hit the F3 key, I can see that a range name
has
now been created. And if I go back to the menu sheet and go into insert hyperlink again, and this time I'm going to click on defined names, data sheet, press OK. And you see it jumps to it. And in this case, if I rename the name of the sheet.
Go on.
And then if I try to hyperlink it again, it jumps to, it will now respond to it.
That is a great trick. So yeah, and if you have a large table of contents with a lot of different sheets, that's a great way to go. Now, hey, one thing I saw you do there that you should go back and explain. Go back to the menu sheet and go up one cell for me. Right, so now you wanted to go select cell B3, but you didn't reach for the mouse to do that. You actually clicked in cell B2, and then you went down. Why didn't you just click on B3 to select B3?
If I had clicked, the hyperlink had already been set up.
Oh, yeah.
So I would have received the error message.
Okay, so you clicked near it and then used the arrow key to get in.
To move down to it, yes.
All right, that's good. That's the same method I use. I'm gonna just give you a trick, though. So here you are. You flew all the way to New York. And now you're going to get this trick. Someone saw me do that in the podcast, and they wrote in, and they said, hey, all you have to do, go ahead and click away somewhere else. And go back to the menu sheet. And now you're going to click and hold on B3. Click and hold on B3 for just, there we go. As soon as it changes from the hand to the plus sign, you can now let go, and you're good to go. So you don't have to scoot in from the side. Although, I still scoot in from the side.
Brilliant. And then just an extra layer to this idea, Bill, is so at the moment we've got our index sheet jumping to every page. Then what would also help then is on every page to be able to jump back to the index.
Right, okay.
So back on the menu sheet, if I just click up sheet menu, enter, and then typically we'd always, the top of each sheet, create a hyperlink, menu. And this reference would actually be put on every sheet. And this would then mean I could always jump to the index sheet and from there jump back to the next sheet that I want to go to.
That's good. Now, so a question that I have. So let's say you had 40 different sheets and we wanted to add the jump back to the menu on all 40. Do you have to do insert hyperlink on each one? Or once I have that first one done, can we copy and paste?
We can certainly copy individually across them.
Okay.
Actually, I've never tried.
All right, good. We'll have to try that on another. Actually, you know what? Let's try it. I mean, just we can edit this part out if it doesn't work. So hit the new worksheet icon a whole bunch of times. Good. Okay, so now go back to your data sheet. So Control-C to copy.
Yep, so Control-C.
And then we're going to be really brave and try group mode. There's no way this will work. All right, so it worked on sheet 3. Isn't that amazing? Let's see if the hyperlink works. That is beautiful. This is good. Paul, the guys from Microsoft who actually design Excel are like 50 feet away from us, or for you, 20 meters, right?
Right, yeah.
And I was going to run back into the room and say, hey, you screwed this up that you didn't give us a way to copy the hyperlink in group mode. But to my surprise, it actually works. So we'll give them credit for that one.
Yes.
Yeah, all right, good. All right, well, hey, Paul, best of luck in ModelOff, and thanks for being here today.
Bill, right. Thank you very, very much.